Bismillah ar-Rahmanir-Rahim. My dear students, here is your reference teacher Muhammad Amjad Saeed from Pakistan International School, Zayed, Saudi Arabia. Today we will continue our lecture number 42 and chapter number 9. And you can solve last question of miscellaneous exercise 8. Dear students, in case of miscellaneous exercise 8, last question, whether the triangle with sides 8, 15, 17 is acute, obtuse or right angle triangle. Remember that you can check your question number 7 and 8. 8 cm side, 15 cm and 17 cm sides are given. So definitely they will satisfy the Pythagoras theorem as this will be c square is equal to a square plus b square. And left hand side will be equal to right hand side, 289 is equal to 289. So in this way, the last question is exactly according to question number 8, first part. Because in first part we proved that the triangle is right angle triangle. And second part was to find out the angle. So that's why question number 10 you can do very easily with the help of question number 8. Now we are going to start our chapter number 9 and theorem number 1. One and only one circle can pass through 3 non-collinear points. Remember that, what are non-collinear points? First of all, you must understand what are non-collinear points. Non-collinear points are those through which one straight line cannot pass. Non-collinear points are those, the points which do not lie on the same line, they are non-collinear points. For example, you have, these are the points which are collinear. And these are the points which are non-collinear. If you draw the line from two points, third point will be out of that line. And if you draw this line, this point will be out of that line. So these points are known as non-collinear points. After that, you know about the circle. Circle is the locus of points for which the distance of a fixed point from every point remains constant. The distance of every point on the locus of points, on the path of points, from the fixed point, that is known as circle. The fixed point is the center of the circle, and all other points which are equidistant from this point, these points will form the boundary of the circle, or you can say circumference of the circle. Similarly, we have arc. In circle, we have arc. This is arc. Remember that if you have this point, these two points and join them, this is known as segment. This is the arc. This is segment. And if you take the two radii and the central portion and containing that arc, this is known as sector of the circle. So you can check, this is the arc having this angle theta, but there is another arc also. This arc, the bigger arc, this is known as major arc. This is known as minor arc. And here is major arc. The line segment joining the two points of the circle, line segment joining the two points of the circle, that is known as chord. Chord of circle. A special chord which is passing through the center, that is known as
The special chord passing through the center of the circle, joining the two points of the circle, that is known as diameter, and here is chord. So the theorem is theorem number 1 of chapter number 9. Statement of the theorem is one and only one arc, one and only one circle, one and only one circle can pass through three non-collinear points. Dear students, theorem number 1, one and only one circle can pass through three non-collinear points. What is given? Three non-collinear points. Three non-collinear points. What is given? Suppose A, B, C, three non-collinear points. What is to prove? One and only one circle can pass through these points, through points A, B, C. What is given? Three non-collinear points are A, B, and C. To prove is one and only one circle can pass through three points A, B, C. Construction. Join A to B and B to C. Join A to B and B to C. Draw DF perpendicular bisector of AB. You know that how you will draw the perpendicular bisector of AB? You can put your compass here and open the compass more than half and like that. So this is perpendicular bisector of AB. Suppose it is DF. Here is D and this is F. Similarly, draw perpendicular bisector of BC. So in this way you can understand the steps with the help of book, because I am not writing down something given to prove. It can be seen very easily. Actually, the main body of the theorem is proof, and in case of proof we will do, and you can understand what I am telling in given to prove and construction with the help of diagram, and open up the book and keep the book in front of you whenever you are listening these theorems. First of all, what is given? There are three non-collinear points A, B, and C. To prove is one and only one circle can pass three points A, B, and C. Construction. Join A to B and B to C. draw perpendicular bisector of AB as BF and draw perpendicular bisector of BC as HK. They intersect each other at point O. Also join O to A, O to B, and O to C. Construction, I am repeating again. Join A to B and B to C. Draw perpendicular bisector of AB as BF. Draw perpendicular bisector of BC as HK. They intersect each other at point O. Join O with A and B and O with C. So, dear students, these were given to prove an construction. After that, we have proof statements and reasons. Every point on DF, every point on DF is equidistant from A and B. Dear students, this was your theorem number 12.1 in 9th class. You have seen this result. Whenever there is a point on the perpendicular bisector, it will be equidistant from the endpoints of line segment. That was the statement of your theorem 12.1 in 9th class. So every point on DF is at equal distance from A and B, or equidistant from A and B, and particularly O is equidistant from A and B. And particularly OA is equal to OB. Every point on DF is equidistant from A and B. Why? Because DF is perpendicular to AB. Theorem 9.1, but you have seen that. This is construction. And particularly, OA is congruent to OB. This is number one. Dear students, similarly, every point on HK is equidistant from B and C. Equidistant from B and C. Every point on HK is equidistant from B and C as HK is perpendicular to BC. Construction. And particularly OB is congruent to OC. This is number two. Dear students, from 1 and 2 you can check O is the only one common point which is equidistant from A and from B and from C. That is OA is equal to OB is equal to OC from 1 and 2. So dear students, O is the only one point which is common in DF and HK and equidistant from ABC. Hence, O is the circumcenter of the circle. And only one circle can pass through that one. Hence, O is the circumcenter of the circle, and hence one and only one circle can pass through three non-collinear points ABC, because the distance of O is from ABC are equal. So this is circumcenter. These are the points on the circle. So in this way we can draw one circle. I hope that you understood this problem. Dear students, after that we have theorem number 2. And to understand the theorem, I told you, you will keep on opening your books, put your books in front of you, and listen to me carefully, and you can understand the steps of given to prove and construction also. In this way, you will be able, it will be easy for you to understand the theorem. After that, we have theorem number 2. Theorem 9.2. Or rather, this is theorem number 2, chapter number 9. A straight line drawn from the center of the circle to bisect the chord is perpendicular to the chord. Statement is, a straight line drawn from the center of circle. Statement. A straight line. A straight line drawn from the center of circle. From the center of a circle to bisect a chord which is not diameter. Is perpendicular to the chord. Is perpendicular to the chord. Here is the circle with center at O. This is a chord AB. And M is the midpoint of AB. From the center of circle to bisect the chord is perpendicular to the chord. Dear students, now check the statement and look at the diagram. Statement. A straight line drawn from the center of circle. Straight line drawn from the center of circle to bisect the chord. AB is the chord and M is the midpoint. To bisect the chord is perpendicular to the chord. This is to prove. And the previous informations are given. So what is given? A circle with center at O. AB is the chord. And OM is drawn on AB such that M is the midpoint of AB. That is AM is equal to MB, where AB is not the diameter of circle. Again, given is a circle with center at O and AB is a chord. M is a point on AB such that M is the midpoint of AB, means AM is equal to MB. Join OM. After that, to prove is OM is perpendicular to AB. Perpendicular to the chord. This line segment OM is perpendicular to the chord. So to prove is OM is perpendicular to AB. Construction is join O with A and O with B. Join O with A and O with B. So dear students, what is given? A circle with center at O such that AM is equal to MB, that is M is the midpoint of AB, and AB is not the diameter of circle. To prove is OM perpendicular to AB. Construction is join O to A and O to B. Then proof is proof statements and reasons. In the correspondence of triangle OAM and triangle OBM. In the correspondence of triangle OAM and OBM, OA is congruent to OB. Radii of same circle. Radii of same circle. AM is congruent to MB. This is given. OM is congruent to OM. Common. Dear students, triangle OAM is congruent to triangle OBM side postulate. So you have these two triangles are congruent. If the two triangles are congruent, then angle OMA is congruent to triangle OMB. So measurement of angle OMA is congruent to measurement of angle OMB. Corresponding angles of congruent triangles. Corresponding angles of congruent triangles. Corresponding angles of congruent triangles. OAOMA. OMA is equal to OAB. But measurement of angle OMA plus OMB is equal to 180 degree. Supplementary angles postulate. Supplementary angles postulate. Dear students, you can check. But OMA is equal to OMB. So you can write down angle OMA plus angle OMA is equal to 180 degree. Here is from 1. Because OMA is equal to OMB, so instead of OMB, we can apply OMA. So angle 2 into angle OMA. That is 180 degree. So measurement of angle OMA is equal to 180 over 2, that is 90 degree. So dear students, if this is 90 degree, then definitely angle OMB is also 90 degree. Also, angle OMB is equal to 90 degree. Supplement of 90 degree is 90 degree. Hence, OM is perpendicular to AB. Because of this 90 degree, you can say OM is perpendicular to AB. That is your theorem number 2. Dear students, I hope that you understood this theorem. After that, we are given theorem number 4. According to your syllabus, theorem number 4. What is theorem number 4?
Theorem number 4 is, if two chords of circles are congruent, then they will be equidistant from the centers. If two chords of a circle are congruent, then they will be equidistant from the center. This is your theorem number 4. It is not so difficult, inshallah, to do it. Okay, dear students, keep on revising. Keep on revising your syllabus and particularly the theorems. I am giving you the suggestion that first of all, you can prepare your theorem first, because small theorems can come in B section even, and long theorem may come in C section. So first of all, you must prepare the theorem. Then you must go to the questions of your different exercise of theorems, exercises of the theorems. So it is better to prepare the theorem first, and then you can find the solution. You can revise your questions of your theorem exercises. So in this way, take the priority of theorem first and second place to the theorem exercises. Similarly, you must revise the whole syllabus from chapter number 1 to 7, and it will be easy for you. And inshallah, after completion of this practical geometry and theorem portion, I will go back to theorem chapter number 6 and chapter number 5 and 4 like that. What was added in your revised reduced syllabus, inshallah, we will do it. Don't worry, and we will complete this portion also at the end of your chapter number 13. Inshallah, we will do these questions at the end, so that you can have better idea about your paper pattern, better idea about your whole syllabus, because it is necessary to prepare the paper according to board pattern. So we need algebra portion, theorem portion, and even practical geometry portion. Okay, Allah Hafiz and Assalamu alaikum.